Hello everyone, welcome to the week 4 maths 1 graded assignment solution video. So let's begin our discussion with the first question. So in this first question there are two graphs given, one for line LX and for another one for another one is for parabola P of X. So first let us write the equation of these two. So this line is passing through 3,0 and 0,-9. So slope will be equal to like 9 divided by 3, that will be equal to 3, and its equation will be y minus 0 will be equal to 3 times x minus 3. So that means y will be equal to 3x minus 9, and for this parabola the equation will be like y will be equal to a times x minus 3 the whole square, and it is also passing through 0,27. So substitute it, okay. So at x is equal to 0, the value of y is 27. So 27 will be equal to 8 times 9, so a will be equal to 3. So here we know the equation of these two, so y will be equal to 3 times x minus 3 whole square. So moving to the option, okay, so it is asking about which of the following represents the graph P of X, that is parabola equation divided by L of X. So parabola equation was 3 times x minus 3 whole square. Okay. Once again, please. X minus 3 whole square divided by, and the line equation was 3 times x minus 3. Okay. So it will give x minus 3. So we have to find which one of these graph will be y equal to x minus 3. So x minus 3, so y is equal to x minus 3. When we substitute y is equal to 0, then x will be equal to 3. So x intercept will be 3 and y intercept will be minus 3. Okay. So this one is the correct depicting graph for y equal to x minus 3. Okay. Moving to the second question. So the second question is basically there are two functions f of x and g of x. One of the roots are from this set, okay. So we have to choose the set of correct options regarding f of x and g of x based on these five statements. So first let us begin with let us consider the function f of x, where f of x is given by x cube minus 4x square minus 17x plus 60, and one of the roots is from this set. So let us substitute x is equal to 3 in this equation, this function, so it will become 7 minus 9 times 4 36 minus 51 plus 60. Okay, so this will become 87 and this will become 87, so that means it is equal to 0. So that means x is equal to 3 is one of its roots. So let's find it's another root, the other two roots. Okay, so it is x cube minus 4x square minus 17x plus 60. It should be divided by x minus 3. Okay? So x square, x cube minus 3x square, and it will become minus x square minus 17x. So minus x minus, and it will become plus. So it will balance. So it will become minus 20 plus 60. Okay, so it will become minus 20. So the factorization for f of x will be like x minus 3 and x square minus x minus 20. So that means it is x minus 3 and x minus 5 x plus 4. Okay. So similarly for g of x we will find its root from the given set. So let me erase this part. So the g of x is x cube plus 5x square minus 8x minus 2. So let us substitute 2 here. So it will become like 8 plus 20 minus 16 minus 12. So this will become 28, this will become 28, that will be 0, okay. So that means x equal to 2 is root of g of x. So let's divide it by x minus 2, x cube plus 5x square minus 8x minus 12, okay. So here it will become x square x cube minus 2x square, okay. Balance it will become 7x square minus 8x, so it will 7x square minus 14x, okay. So this will become 6x minus 12, so it will be so the factorization for g of x will be x minus 2 and x square plus 7x plus 6, so it will be equal to x minus 2, x plus 6 and x plus 1. Graph, so let's represent it on a number line. So minus 6, minus 1 and 2, okay. So it will be like positive, negative, then negative, okay. And for f of x, this is for g of x, and we are trying for f of x now. So f of x is this one, 3, 5, minus 4, okay. So minus 4, 3 and 5. So for x greater than 5 it will be positive, negative, okay. So now moving to the options. So the first option is f of x cut the x axis 3, 5, 4, okay. No, it's cut the x axis minus 4, so that's why this is incorrect. The second statement says g of x cut the x axis 2, minus 6, minus 1, 2, minus 6, minus 1, that is correct. The third statement says for x belongs to minus 6 to 2, g of x is positive. Minus 6 to 2, g of x is positive. Let us suppose here it is minus 6 and here it is 2. So that's not correct. Okay. Fourth option is f of x is negative when minus 4, it is including minus 4. So that's why it is incorrect. And the last statement says the first function g of x is positive when x belongs to minus infinity to minus 6, union minus 1, 2. Minus 2, okay. So minus 1 to minus 2, let us suppose this is minus 2, so minus infinite and to minus 6 it is negative, so that's why this is correct. So for the second question only one option is correct, this one. Going to the third question, okay. So there is a rectangular box whose length is x, height is 3 unit less than the length x minus 3 and the width, or we can say d, okay, breadth is 5 unit more than the height, okay. So this is x minus 3 plus 5, so basically this is x plus 2. If the volume of the rectangular box is 24 unit cube, the value of x, okay. So volume is basically lbh, so basically it will be x plus 2, x minus 3, okay, and it is equal to 24. So what we'll do is we will not expand it, okay, just factorize it, 24, 3, 2, 2 and 2, okay, 8 times 3. So we have to choose this set of factorization from this one, okay. So when we have, okay, so first x minus 3 should be greater than 0, so that means x should be greater than. So let us suppose this is like 4 times 3 times 2, we can take, let us suppose x, we will, let us assume that x is equal to 4, then this will become 6 and 1 will become, one side will become 1 unit of length, so the volume will be equal to 24. This is satisfying the whole equation, okay. So the 4 will be the correct option from out of these four options. Going to the fourth question, consider the polynomial function f of x of degree 4 which intersects the x-axis at 2, minus 3, minus 4, okay. So let me draw. So it intersects the x-axis at minus 4, minus 3 and 2, okay. And moreover, it is a, let me use different color, f of x is less than 0 for x belongs to 1 to 1 to 2. Let us suppose this is 1. So here it is negative, and f of x is greater than 0 when x belongs to minus 1 to 1. Okay, minus 1 to 1. Here it is positive. So that means 1 should also be the root of this function f of x. Okay, so then only this can hold true. Already studied in application of derivative LMBT, Lagrange mean value theorem, and subsequently the application of it. Okay, so that's why one should be the root of this root of the function f of x. So now moving to the option, so these two will be eliminated from the correct option. Now out of these two, we will check in which of these two option one will hold true. Okay, so let us check the first one, this one. So substitute 1 here, so it will become 1 minus 5 minus 7 minus 15 minus 24. Okay, so this is not equal to 0. Going to this option, so it will become 1 plus 4 minus 7 minus 22 plus 24 and 529, and it is 29, so it is giving 0. So that's why the option 2 will be the correct answer for the question number 4. Going to the fifth question. So consider a polynomial function f of x that is given by minus 1 by 300, x minus 2 whole square, x minus 3, x plus 1 whole square, x plus 4, and x plus x minus 5. So based on these given function f of x, we have to choose the correct set of options. So let me draw a rough estimate for this function f of x. Okay, so it is cutting the so its root is like 2, 3, minus 1, minus 4, and 5. Okay, so minus 4, minus 1, and 2, 3, and 5. So for x greater than 5, it is positive, and this whole is becoming negative. Okay, so it will start from, okay, like this one, negative portion, and at x equal to 2 and x equal to minus 1, its direction will not change. Okay, so like this is going to, okay, so it's rough sketch will be like this one. Okay, so now moving to the option, f of x has exactly 7 turning points, so 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so that's why this is correct. This is correct. Okay, slope is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, the third statement says fx is neither even nor odd function. That's correct. The fourth statement says in the interval 3 to 5, okay, f of x is increasing. First it is increasing, then decreasing. Okay, so that's why this is correct. The last statement says f of x is negative when x belongs to minus 1 to 2. Yeah, that is also correct. So we have to choose the correct set of option. So moving to the sixth question. So here a polynomial given by p of x that is equal to x to raise 4 4x cube plus x plus 10, and q of x is x cube plus 2x square minus 6, and m of x is the equation of a straight line passing through the point 2 comma q of 2. So q of 2 will be equal to 8 plus 8 minus 6. Okay, 16 minus 6, that will be equal to 10. So it is passing through 2 comma 10, and the slope is 3. So equation will be like y minus 10 will be equal to 3x minus 2. So it is 3x minus 6, and it will be equal to plus 10. Okay, so 3x plus 4. Okay, so now we have to find the equation of p of x plus m of x times q of x. So just multiply it. Okay, 3x plus 4 multiplied by x cube plus 2x square minus 6. Okay, it will become 3x to raise 4 plus 6x cube minus 18x, okay, and plus 4x cube plus 8x square minus 18 sorry 4x cube plus 8x square minus 24. So it will become 3x to raise 4 plus 10x cube plus 8x square minus 18x minus 24. We have to add p of x, so and p of x is equal to x to raise 4 x cube plus x plus 10. Okay, so just add it. So x to raise 4, 3x to raise 4 will become 4x to raise 4, 4x cube, 10x cube, 14x cube plus 8x square plus x minus 18x minus 17x and minus 14. Okay, so 4x cube, 14x square, 8x square minus 17x minus 14. And this is also giving minus 14, but it is 2x cube. So that's why this is incorrect. Okay, all these options are incorrect, only one is true. So the 8th question is and MB. Basically, this is a very long statement, and it is basically asking about, so the sum of the x intercept of the function f of x. Okay, so just equate it to 0. So f of x will be equal to 0. So x square minus 23 and times x minus 10 whole cube minus 1. We have to equate it to 0, so x will become like plus minus root 23 and the other roots will be like x minus 10 will be equal to 1, so x will be equal to 11. So we have to find the sum of these roots. So okay, so these two will equate to 0, so the left out will be 11. So we have to find the sum of x coordinate of the all the prolongations. So it will be equal to 11. Going to the 9th question, the Ministry of Road Transportation and Highways want to connect 3 aspirational districts of with 2 roads R1 and R2, and if 2 roads are connected if they intersect. Okay, so the shape of 2 roads R1 and R2 given by this polynomial, and so it is asking about the coordinate of the third aspirational district. Okay, if first two are x intercept of f of x and g of x. So basically, so the first two districts are at x equal to 15 and x equal to 13. So we have to find the x coordinate of the third aspirational district. Okay, so just equate it. F of x is equal to g of x. So that means x minus 15, x minus 13 whole square plus x minus 15, x minus 13 will be equal to 0. Take out common. X minus 15, x minus 13. Okay, so here it is x minus 13, and here it will be 1, will be equal to 0. This already gave x equal to 15 and 13, so it will give the x coordinate of the third aspirational district. So x minus 12 will be equal to 0, so x will be equal to 12. Moving to the last question of the week 4. So there is a polynomial R of x whose equation is polynomial function which is obtained at the quotient after dividing the polynomial p of x, this one, by polynomial q of x. So we have to choose which of the this out of this graph which will represent the r of x. Okay, so p of x is x plus 5 x minus 3 x square minus 4. Of x is x minus 2 x plus 2. Just divide it. So basically x square minus 4 can be written as x plus 2 x minus 2. So this will balance out each other. So the r of x will be simply x plus 5 and x minus 3. So this graph will be like it will cut at minus 5 and 3. Okay, like this one. So out of this 4 options, this seems correct. Okay, so we will solve the question number 8. Okay, question number 7 in another video. So thank you and have a great day.